Seven AI drug stocks are the topic of today's presentation. And while you see AI mentioned pretty much everywhere, it's actually been around for quite a while. So back in 2017, AI algorithms bested the world's one of the top Go champions in the world. And shortly after that, AlphaFold, which was an algorithm from DeepMind, Google's DeepMind, then mastered protein folding. So it's able to predict the structure of 200 million known proteins. So using AI for drug discovery really makes sense, especially when you consider how broken the process is. Now, also what's worth considering is how large this opportunity is. So it's about a $1.4 trillion global market, pharmaceuticals. If you want to look at where all that money is being spent, it's largely in the United States, which has the highest per capita expenditure on pharmaceuticals behind Germany. Only the U.S. and New Zealand can market prescription drugs directly to consumers, and these commercials are almost satire in the sheer number of side effects that they have to list in a very litigious society. So the U.S. was the largest national pharmaceutical market, as you can see here, over 42% of total pharmaceutical spending worldwide. So companies that are able to bring drugs to market more efficiently and have those drugs enjoy better efficacy, they stand to make a lot of money with their platforms. And the companies we're going to talk about today, there's seven of them: Abcellera, Relay Therapeutics, Recursion Pharmaceuticals, Exscientia, Benevolent AI, BioXcel Therapeutics, Lantern Pharma, and I have a mystery company here. So this is one that we're invested in, but I'm going to tell you later why we're not going to mention that in the context of AI drug discovery stock. So this is a, I suppose, a 2x2 here that shows the placement of some of the companies we just mentioned. Some aren't on here. But what's interesting to take away from this is when you look at the range here, what's on each axis. So going from left to right, you can see that on the left-hand side, you have computational focus. Moving to the right, you have next-gen wet and dry lab integration. You see Recursion up there in the corner. Well, also going up and down, well, let's just move to the next slide. It explains it a little better. So companies that are lower on that spectrum have no disclosed clinical stage assets in their internal pipelines, limited computational capability, and no strategic partnership. So contrast those types of companies to ones that have a mature clinical pipeline, advanced computational capabilities, and partnerships with pharma. So we go back looking at this list, everything above that line that goes across the horizon there would be in a better shape than everything below. So let's start talking about some of these companies. And what we'll do is start with going over some criteria that we use when analyzing drug discovery companies. Let's see, AI drug discovery companies. Size, so bigger is better at raising capital, it becomes easier, and the likelihood of these firms trading on a major exchange where there's liquidity increases, and all the firms that we're going to discuss today, at least of now, trade on major exchanges. Pipeline progress, as we mentioned before. Runway, this is how long they can survive based on the cash they have on hand divided by some estimated burn rate. If they need to raise, then they'll have to give away more equity or take on more debt. The number of top 10 pharma partners, we like to look at that. Total drug pipeline, this is the breadth of potential wins. And then the drugs in clinical development, that's depth, the progress of potential wins. So let's start with the first firm, $56 million company that when it comes to size, we won't invest in firms with a market cap of less than $1 billion, but we're still going to cover the three companies, on actually four companies on this list that are below that cutoff. And Lantern is one of them. So they had a press release a few weeks ago talking about this successful IND application for this candidate drug. They said the first of Lantern's drug candidates to be developed entirely internally. Well, this is a $56 million company with $56 million in cash. You may be tempted to think, well, it's a free drug development firm. Well, more like a free money pit. So your typical drug candidate, this is from Deloitte, from discovery through clinical trials is an expense that now exceeds $2 billion per therapy on average. So you have to think, how is Lantern, without a partner, going to be able to fund the development of this candidate? And the market seems to believe they're not going to have much progress in that respect. Now, when it comes to this firm, BioXcel, we've written about most of the companies that we're going to talk about today, and I'm going to put links to those research pieces, a fair number of them, not all, there's a lot, in the description of this video. One of those was a firm called BioXcel, and when we looked at their S1 filing when they had their IPO, we saw a convoluted structure of platforms, license grants, companies, subsidiaries. We couldn't understand it, and frankly, after a while, we didn't want to. It was just an absolute mess. If your average retail investor can't figure out what a company does, they shouldn't invest. And pay no attention to what's going on behind the curtain is a common response where some fearless leader that the cheerleaders will always point to is here to guide you through the mess. No, you shouldn't need somebody on Substack to explain to you what a company does. You don't need anybody to explain. You should be able to figure it out fairly easily. And as you can see, when you don't understand what a company does, then you run into problems. And this firm has run into some big problems. You can see just in the last 24 hours, the fraud investigation relating to some Alzheimer's data. You just walk away from this stuff. These firms are risky enough. You don't mess around with that. That brings us then to a firm called Benevolent. And here's their current pipeline. And one of the candidates, their lead candidate, is actually missing from this pipeline because it actually failed in a phase 2A trial. And it says here, denting the prospects of the program and raising questions about the AI-enabled model that proposed the approach. That's not good. They have a top 10 pharma partner, AstraZeneca. Looks like doing some chemistry and lead optimization. But what do you think AstraZeneca's thinking about when they see this flop? And you can see this article here. Benevolent AI makes deep cuts after mid-phase flop, laying off 180 and shrinking lab footprint. That's not the direction that you want your AI drug discovery platform going. And you see here the statement on their site. It says, in May of 2023, we paused all target ID development programs with future optionality to reinitiate these on a case-by-case prioritized basis, resource permitting. If there's any chance or change to this, we can update and wrap up in communications later in the year. This is not positive communication. If your lead candidate bombs, or if a major pharma partner bails and suddenly it's now being developed in-house while management tries to spin that as a positive, these are red flags, and it means we immediately move on to the next option. Relay Therapeutics, three active clinical trials. You can see here they're listed in terms of the progress they're making. Genentech, that particular candidate, only Genentech is releasing information on how that's progressing. And you can see here that they have these active clinical trials that are making some good progress, but this really lacks the breadth we're looking for. The ideal platform doesn't just have one or two success stories. It has a whole pipeline of them, and probably Abcellera looks the best when it comes to breadth. But we did a piece, and you can delve into that on Relay. It didn't have the appeal, the breadth that we were looking for, though there certainly is some depth here. So speaking of Abcellera, they have somewhere around 177 programs under contract, about $800 million in cash. We'll talk about cash in a second. They have 9 molecules in the clinic, so that's their depth. That looks good. But you ought to watch our recent video on Abcellera because it was quite frankly, a bit disturbing. So just 28% of their clinical pipeline will demonstrate the promise of their AI-powered antibody discovery platform, while 43% relates to their specialized rodent platform that they bought. So that's not good. They have some animal therapeutics they're developing. That's not appealing. That doesn't make the big bucks. So when you look at the potential here in this right-hand table, this is rather old, and I just pulled this from our last article on Abcellera, so probably a year old. But it shows the milestones. You can see preclinical, very little, clinical, more, regulatory, more, commercial, even more. So you can expect that widening of that revenue pipeline as they progress, and that's why it's so important to see progress, because they start making more money. It helps validate the platform. Then you can see on the right, royalties and how they have been increasing those based on each bucket of contracts. So Absolera is one of the two AI drug discovery firms we like. We'd like to see more progress. And certainly, I think after that last video, there was some concerns around their pipeline and how much of it would actually validate their AI-powered antibody discovery program. Now, that brings us then to Exscientia. And this is a table that was taken from the last article that we did, and I pulled that up. You can see here it's there's a lot of breadth, right? Partners include Bristol Myers Squibb, Sanofi, Bayer, and Evotech. So some big names there. But then when you go to their website now, what's interesting is that they've really refined that down, and I don't know why that is. Maybe they narrowed their focus, and all those other items are on the back burner. I don't know, but you can see here that this is one of two firms that claims to have the first AI-designed drug to enter human clinical trials. And the one to watch here is this EXS21546. It's along the top there, and it's majority-owned alongside Evotech. And latest news on that, it's the company's most advanced drug, cancer immunotherapy treatment, developed in just 9 months out of only 163 compounds. As I said, they claim this is the first AI-designed drug to enter human clinical trials. The phase 1A clinical trial began in December 2020. Initial results were released as promised in June of 2022. And now they're moving on to phase 1B2 to test the drug in patients with solid tumors as of their last quarter. In May, the first patient was dosed in the phase 1-2 Ignite clinical trial of this compound. So that's one to watch, because when there is a successful AI-developed drug, it's going to make the news, and that rising tide is going to lift all boats. That brings us to Recursion, which claims to have one of the largest, broadest, and deepest pipelines of any technology-enabled drug discovery company. We've written about them in a number of pieces. They initiated 5 clinical trials in 2022, including 3 phase 2 programs. So they definitely have the depth. Partners include Roche and Genentech, Bayer, 9 therapies in their pipeline, as I said, 3 phase 2, and over a dozen discovery programs. It's good to look at runway for these firms, and that's difficult to estimate. What we typically do is take the last quarter operating costs and try to annualize that. In the case of Relay, they actually say that the $938 million in cash they have will only last them into 2025. So that's from the company before they have to raise again. And when these firms do go to raise, the quality of that raise is an indicator of just how well their platforms are doing. And you see here Recursion has $473 million, so a lesser amount of cash relative to the others. We calculate that runway through next year. Of course, that's just based on estimates. But this is a firm that actually, if you recall from that previous spectrum regarding a wet lab, they actually use computer vision and look at how cells react to drugs. It's super cool stuff. And I believe they're based out of Utah. We've been watching them for quite a while. We're quite excited about their platform, but you have to be careful about stories. Now, that brings us to the mystery stock, which is Schrodinger. This happens to be a firm we're holding in our tech stock portfolio of 37 tech stocks. And one thing I think that people think is that I'm just some YouTube wanker that's talking out his ass, and that's definitely true. What they don't know is that we've been researching and publishing content on tech for over a decade, so our YouTube channel is relatively new. We have over 2,300 research pieces that have been written over the past decade by myself and our team of researchers and writers. Life sciences topics, we have 330 pieces on those, and then 26 on drug discovery, 17 on computational drug discovery. You can see here this article in the bottom. It says 9 computational drug discovery startups using AI. That's when we were digging into the potential of AI for drug discovery. That's right around the time Substack came out, so we've been doing this for quite a while. The piece above that, how computational chemistry helps drug discovery, I went to San Francisco and met with a firm called 2XAR. I think that refers to the fact that the two gentlemen that were founders, they had the same name, Andrew Radin. And one of those gentlemen was kind enough to explain to us exactly how this industry was unfolding. And it was very informative. And you can see here at the top, a computational chemistry IPO from Schrodinger. And that's exactly, you can read that piece. That's exactly what they do. When we had written a follow-up piece talking about Schrodinger dabbling in AI, their legal team contacted us and said that was absolutely not the case. You can go sift through their collateral and you won't see any mention of AI. And that's fair enough, however they want to describe themselves. But I would recommend, I'll put in the description of this video, a very recent piece that looks at their business model and how they're progressing. It's a very interesting firm. Now, I wanted to touch a little bit about thinking outside the box, and that means that we need to consider all the firms out there, not just the ones that are publicly traded. So you see this object in the picture here. I can't recall the specific name of that, but this is located in Budapest, Hungary, and this is the building that I went to interview the gentleman who invented that object. And what's so cool about it is it's the only known geometric shape that if you drop it from any angle, it always writes itself. So quite cool. And he was quite the innovator, and he had put together this startup that used I believe it was AR-enabled gloves for signing, so people could sign and have it immediately rendered as text on the screen. Very, very cool stuff, and it was a really interesting company. But what I thought was more interesting was a firm that I met in Budapest called Turbine, and if you want to read this piece, it's super interesting. It's called Simulating Cancer Cells Using AI, and that was back in 2019. I saw quite recently, they raised more money. That was the second raise that I saw they're doing, so they must be doing pretty good. But what they were doing is building virtual cells, which is cool as hell. So ultimately, if you can render the entire drug discovery model in a digital twin of a human, that would be the optimal way to go. So the basic steps for drug discovery are find a new protein in the body to hit with a molecule, find molecules that bind to protein in body, and once you find a hit, then turn it into something that could be introduced to a living being. That's the basic method of discovering drugs, and what Turbine's doing is very cool because, as I said, they're building that digital twin. So there's a lot of ways to skin the cat when it comes to AI drug discovery. Now, just to conclude, we like a few AI drug discovery stocks, but wouldn't consider an investment until we see more steady progression. Only four names we think should be seriously considered: Recursion, Abcellera, Relay, and Exscientia. Ultimately, we'd like to see a leader emerge before investing. And the next milestone, from our perspective, will be the first AI discovered drug that gets approved and marketed. So I'm going to put up another video here, the one I talked about on Abcellera, which is very interesting. But before you watch that, please click the Nanalyze logo here on the right. Subscribe to our channel. Thanks so much for taking the time to watch this today.